The high speed was, it was pretty much set. Yeah, yeah. And the low speed calls for 3 to 4.
Yeah, that's the start.
Yeah. Now I had to back down probably to about 2. It's down. Puppy to goat. Working on my motorcycle. I had them at about 19, maybe 18, and I opened them up 20. That's what it calls for. Ain't it nice? But look what I'm doing. I'm nastying it all up.
Well, you're just covering the paint.
No, I'm talking about the paint, the smutting up my fresh paint.
What happened?
It's got an exhaust leak right there.
Yeah.
Which I'm going to get me one of them expanders. Yeah, to a ratchet gun. Yeah, you liking that, huh?
It's just how you just
all right. Well, that one right there is the one that makes the whole thing turn. Now, there is a mark right there that I've got it pretty much set on that mark, and that seemed to be real close to what it needed to be. Hear something deep throat. Thank you.
popping?
Yeah.
That's a valve tube type. Hmm. I don't know which one, but which one would be determined by which cylinder has less compression than the other. Do you have a compression tester?
At the house, yeah.
Yeah, when you get home, check your compression. Just put your plug and check your compression. Whichever cylinder has the least compression, that's the one that's got a tight valve.
Okay.
Sounds like it might be an intake.
It's got a 3/8 nut behind it.
Yeah, I'm gonna be ready. And it don't have to be much, just enough to make it overlap.
All right, you need a flashlight?
Even better when you stepped out of the way.
I'm sorry?
Even better when you stepped out of the way there.
Yeah, yeah. Get out of your light, huh?
I know. Got a flashlight right here if I need it. Okay, let's start one more time. And you're going to retard it again. I want to watch it when you retard it.
I'd turn it from the bottom.
From the bottom? From here?
Yeah, well, I reckon the whole thing.
Retard it for me. Slowly. That your oil pump doing the clacking? A clacking noise, that dry oil pump in there?
It might be.
Yeah.
No, it's working fine.
It retarded slowly, taking it all the way retarded. You all the way retarded?
Almost.
Okay,
alright, that's as far as I can go.
Bring it back up.
Alright, that's as far as I can go. Your bite?
Yeah.
Yeah. Let me move out of your light again. Be tough getting in there right now.
Yeah.
It'd be better.
Not only be tough getting in there right now, but you don't adjust valves when they're hot.
Right, right.
You have to wait from cool, which is 8 hours.
Mm-hmm.
Did you know that?
No.
8 hours after you shut it off.
Okay.
Before you can adjust valves. Okay, what are you going to say?
Okay, at the same time, I'll go get me one of them tools to do this pipe a little bit, to make it a little bit bigger.
There you go.
I hear they got them at Harbor Freight. Yeah.
Just for the sake of so it's driving it. The other thing you can do is you can put exhaust.
I've already done that.
Okay.
And I let it, 18 hours wasn't long enough. It blew it out. Now it worked good on the front one. You can still see a little bit there. And put some right here, and it took care of that too, because this was leaking.
Yeah.
But this back one.
Yes, still too loose. These are new pipes, right?
No. This is new. This is about a year old, but I run it too damn lean, and it just screwed it all up. I just put these brand new Petcocks on here. These are from Ed Glasgow, Indian bolts, and he sells those. They don't leak. And yeah, it's pretty neat. Little ball valves.
Yep.
They don't look stock, but they don't look hideous either, you know?
Yeah, I think the carpet is a lot better right now, of course. Minor adjustment.
Sure, go for it.
You have a gasoline problem.
Brand new caps.
Alright. The presser.
Okay, so it's not venting.
Not venting.
Hmm. Now, once you get it cranked up, we'll pull this off and let you see my oil flow.
Yeah.
And my Jerry Greer, excuse me, Kiwi Indian.
Hear that?
Yeah.